producing a record, you want to have gear that's reliable. My whole life I've kind of used API and Neve, and because it's old vintage gear, it's never reliable. And we love the sound, we want it to sound like that, but nothing new has that quite that kind of tone and warmth. So with these preamps, I can keep them close to me. And what's really great about it is while I'm working, they're right beside me and I can make any adjustments to the tracks, because otherwise you'd have to get up and walk over here and do that, or, you know, but with them right beside you, it's very convenient. So I think because of that, I'm using them today because they're dependable and they sound amazing.
So what do you and Daniel Lenoir look for in a preamp? Obviously, you wanted them close to you, but what do the preamps themselves have to be?
I think with the preamp, it needs to be warm and it has to be able to pack a punch at the same time. If you're recording a kick drum, you want to feel that kind of pressure that kick drums give off. A lot of preamps can't handle preamp. A lot of preamps can't handle kick drums because they peak it out. With these ones, because of the pad, it knocks you right back down and you got tons of headroom. So I think with these, we have a larger amount of headroom and we can relax a little bit when you're recording. Peaking your ring.
Yeah, right on. And what are some of the things that make the GP2 special in terms of maybe the specs of the inside?
I think the thing that makes this preamp special is it's hand-built, essentially. You know, it's like one guy, he assembles the whole thing, and like an Aston Martin, it's like a car that was put together by hand. These are preamps that are put together by hand. And I think what a lot of people don't realize is when you do that, and you have an actual board that you're putting resistors on, and you're building it, and you're moving them, and this box has been around for 25 years, I've been working with this box. And what happens is, the sound changes the more you change components and add components. And I think we found the sweet spot on this one, where API doesn't quite have the kind of punch that these have. And I think you can record with these preamps without equalizers. You put a vocal into it and you play it back. You don't need to EQ the vocal after that, because it's a really balanced sound that you get. I've had great results with the preamp. I just finished the new Neil Young record, and I think him hearing his guitar come back as loud and warm as it did, he was quite impressed. He didn't know how the hell we were doing it, and when I explained to him at the end of the day that we were using Canadian preamps, he was kind of stoked. I remember I've been using this preamp last year on Robert Plant, an Alison Krauss session, and at that point, it was kind of like the first time I'd really put the preamp through a good kind of recording session. I've been using it off and on for quite a few years, but this latest version we got is that was the record where I was working with Robert, and I really found a really great sound from his vocal. Just using a 58 right into this box, and you hear it back, and you can't believe that it's a 58. You know, it sounds like a 47. So I think that was really the first time that the box really like jumped out and everybody really stood back and said, wow, this sounds amazing. The whole box is a wow factor. You touch the knob and you feel how smooth it is. I went through a year of looking at knobs and finding the right pots and feel and the size of the knob. And I think when you put your hand on this and you feel the glide of it, it's pretty incredible. And each notch, you can remember where you were like a week ago, you know, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stops. So that way it helps with documenting your sound. But I think the only wow factor you're going to get with this box is by plugging it in and turning it on and really hearing for yourself.